EHAs and BHAs are type of hydroxy acids. You can find both acids in variety of mediums, such as cleansers, toners, moisturizers, serums, scrubs, peels, and masks. This is going to be a two-part tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to be discussing how to prepare your skin for the treatment of EHAs and BHA exfoliants that you can purchase over the counter. If you never exfoliated your skin before and you want to start, there are several steps that you need to pay close attention so you're not going to get any reactions. And most of all, you will need to prepare your skin very slowly. Because this is something that you just don't put on top of your skin without paying any attention of the outcomes and then go into the sun, you know what you're gonna get? Hyperpigmentation, irritation, not a good thing. If you go to an aesthetic spa or to the dermatologist, they will take certain steps, protocols, to prep your skin. Now, although an esthetician can do up to 40% and a dermatologist up to 70% strength, so they need to be very careful before they proceed with a treatment. Now, the over-the-counter, they're not as strong. The strength is much lower. However, if you're using them incorrectly or if you overlayer them, you may cause certain irritation and reaction on your skin. Very quickly, if this is your first time on my channel, welcome. I do many educational tutorials and also I provide education online. If you want additional information, check my website. If you have not subscribed yet, please consider it. So let's get started. So before I go into the steps and the combination of different peels, which that is on part two, we need to talk about contraindications. Just don't apply a product and just hope for the best. If you're prone to keloid scarring, be careful. If you have a darker skin, certain products will cause hyperpigmentation. So that's something that you have to be very careful. If you have open wounds or very active acne, this will irritate more and then you'll have to wait until it subsides. Not a very good experience. Now, something else, if you are on antibiotics, the antibiotic itself will thin out the skin. So it is not a very combination when your skin is thinning and then you're doing peeling. You will get a reaction. If you're pregnant or if you're breastfeeding and you go, how come? Well, because studies have shown that a very small percentage of that chemical was detected in the epidermis and also the dermis. Now, the dermis is highly vascularized. If it's detected in the dermis, which is highly vascularized, that means that the peel is also, even minute, in the blood. The studies were done with a higher percentage, like the 30% and above. So let's keep ourselves safe and also our babies. Now, before you start with a treatment of 30% chemical peel, I know, you are so excited. You got your product just arrived and you want to just put it on your skin. But there is a couple of weeks of preparation. I would advise for you to maybe start with a mild cleanser with salicylic acid or a moisturizer with 5% HA. So that your skin gets accustomed or used to these actives. Now, if you get a reaction, you should have a solution of baking soda because the baking soda is alkaline. The acid is acidic. So if you're getting a reaction, just splash some baking soda and water. Another step that I would advise is to do a 24-hour patch test of the product that you're wanting to use. This is a very good habit for any new product. So how to do a patch test is very simple. Get a little bit of the product that you're using, the HA, BHA, or whatever, and just get a little dab, and you can put it in behind your ear and leave it there for 24 hours. And if you don't want to do it there, just put it like in the middle here of your elbow, and then put a bandage and leave it for 24 hours. If you're getting a reaction, a rash, now you know not to use that product. Few days before the chemical exfoliant, you do not want to do the following. No waxing of your face, and if you're a man, no shaving. Some women do dermal planning, please don't do that. Any physical scrubs, because all these products or methodologies do remove some of your skin. So you're going to irritate your skin or thin out your skin, and then you're going to apply the HAs and BHAs. The outcome might not be so good. Finally, the day of the treatment, I would advise to do it at nighttime. Start with a mild cleanser, no acids, no toners with salicylic acid, none of that, just a mild cleanser. Tap dry your skin, apply DHA or BHA or whatever exfoliant that you're using, and be very careful that you follow the protocol. So if they're saying 1 minute and then rinse, do 1 minute. If they're saying you can leave it on for 10 minutes, leave it on for 10 minutes and then rinse it. Please be very careful of the protocol of the product that you are using. After you remove the product completely, just give it like an extra rinse, you can apply a serum, a hyaluronic acid, because it brings moisture to your skin. I advise to do it at nighttime, so you can apply a night cream and allow the skin to rejuvenate. Go to bed and know that you have pampered your skin, and your skin will thank you. For the next few days, you want to keep yourself away from direct sun, and you need to use a good mineral sunscreen and a good hat if you go outside. Also, purchase yourself a good skincare line, nothing too complicated. There's a link below. I hope that you found this video to be useful and walk away with very simple and easy steps on how to correctly use these exfoliants. Consult your esthetician or a professional for more information. Remember to treat yourself with love and respect. And see you next week for part two. Take care.